Welcome to TC Kidz. I'm the narrator this month. Now, I know what you're thinking. I can't see you. Well, that's the point. Today, I will be your guide through TC Kidz. Now, enough from me. Let's get started.
Hey, TC Kidz. I am Stephanie, and today is going to be absolutely incredible. You know, I was just thinking about how cool the Bible is. It's unlike any other book that I've ever read. It has incredible adventures and really awesome lessons, and it is showing me how to live my life.
Wait, is she talking about the Bible? I thought I was supposed to talk about that. Anyway, I guess since she's already introduced it, we can keep going on with the story.
Yeah, the Bible is so cool, and today we're gonna learn that the Word is alive. Not like breathing and living, but it still applies to our lives today.
Wow, will she ever stop talking about the Bible? We have things to do. We need to get along with what we are going to do today. Let's meet some of our other people in today's story. Ah, here we are. I love the kitchen. The smell of freshly baked cookies, the sight of dishes, and three kids. Wait, that wasn't part of our story.
Welcome to the kitchen. Now, today we're learning all about scripture. And this is gonna be fun because we're gonna do a little baking competition. Are you guys ready?
Yes.
Wonderful. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give each of you a different Bible story that you're gonna have to decorate a cookie for. Okay, now let me see. Sophia, I'm thinking the creation story. You got it? Okay, that's Genesis 1. You should go check it out if you haven't. Dunamis, I'm thinking Jesus feeds the 5,000. Okay, I think we're getting it. And Amaya, you're gonna do Noah's Ark. Y'all got it?
Yes.
Okay, grab your cookies. And let's get started in 3, 2, 1.
Oh, I like this game. My money is on the girl. She seems to have some strategy for each cookie she's decorating. Now while they're doing this, let's go check back in on Stephanie. Ah, it seems as if she is still looking at her Bible. What could she possibly be doing?
Oh, hey, I am so excited that you're here. I am still reading my Bible, but as I was reading, I thought it might be fun for us to play a game. I'm gonna read a part of the Bible verse and you're gonna tell me, well, you won't tell me, but whoever's around you, you're gonna tell them how that verse ends. All right, I think.
Oh, this will be easy.
Okay, we're gonna start with 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16. It says, all scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, reproof, for correction, and blank.
Oh, I know, it is. And for my eyes to read.
For instruction in righteousness.
Oh, I was so close. I mean, I have to be able to get this one right.
Okay, I think we should jump into the next one. It's in Matthew 24, 35. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never.
Oh, I got this one. Be the same.
The right answer is pass away.
Come on, Stephanie, give me one more. Just one more.
That's it. I don't know how you guys think you did, but I hope you did a good job. I just love God's word. It truly is an amazing tool.
Well, since the game is over, I guess, stand up and worship.
Come on, get up on your feet and let's worship. There you go. Get loose. And jump. This life in the water. There you go. Jump.
I jump into
Next time. Come on. There's that nay-nay. Come on. Hey. You. Yeah. Great job.
These are beautiful cookies. I don't know whose is better. Let's see who they choose as a winner. Let's take a peek at these cookies.
Okay, you have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Everything down, everything down. Great job, everyone. These cookies are amazing. Now, I'm gonna give each of you just a couple seconds to explain how you decorated your cookie and why. We're gonna start with mine. So what was your Bible story?
Noah and the Ark.
Noah's Ark. And why did you decorate it like this?
Because.
Well, what's the blue for?
The ocean.
That's the ocean. And then, is that Noah?
Yeah.
She put Noah on the actual ark, everyone. Incredible, incredible. And who's coming with us?
The animals.
The animals. That's great. Good job, Maya. Okay, Dynamis, which Bible story did you have?
That's where I had Jesus. And Jesus fed 1,000 fish.
He did.
You're right.
Fish,
right.
And some bread.
So this right here?
Yeah.
This is for me.
Oh, okay.
But this.
That, okay.
This is, represent. This is Jesus, right?
Wow,
here.
Okay, there's Jesus. Jesus is on the cookie.
Oh my, okay, this, all of this, this,
yeah.
This is wonderful. This is all the fish.
Yeah, oh, okay.
We're gonna do.
It's good? Yeah, okay, good. Glad it tastes good. Who are these people?
Oh, these are the disciples.
Those are the disciples helping pass out the fish and the bread. Yeah. Great job, Dynamis. Love it. Okay. Last but not least, what Bible story did you have?
I did Genesis 1, when God first made the earth.
When God first made the earth. Walk us through it. What did you, how did you decide what to put on there?
I put a fish with water.
With the water, perfect.
And then I put like animals, and then I put stars and
which are all things God created. Great job. You guys did incredible. Now, I know I said this was a competition, but I think you all are winners tonight. Give yourselves a round of applause. And did you guys learn something new about the Bible?
Yeah.
Oh, for sure, for sure. Let's take it away to our Bible.
That was a great job decorating those cookies. Now I think it's time to read our Bible story.
This week's Bible story is found in the book of Acts chapter 8, and it is about a man named Philip. Now, after the Holy Spirit came and filled all of his people, then they were able to travel from city to city and teach the good news, or the gospel. Now, Philip loved God, and he traveled to Samaria to teach the gospel. He was able to heal and teach, just like Jesus did. While Philip was in Samaria, he encountered a man from Ethiopia. The man had a question about the Bible. He didn't understand why one scripture was a certain way. When the Ethiopian man heard that Philip was in town, he listened very close to what Philip had to say, so that he could figure out what the scripture meant. At one point, Philip got the opportunity to speak to this man. As the man and Philip talked, Philip was able to tell the man about the good news of Jesus. Not only was Philip able to talk to the man about the truth in the Bible, he also got the right context. He was able to share the truth of Jesus and what he did on the cross. The Ethiopian man left, and he was very encouraged, and he knew the good news. That is the same good news that we get to experience today. With Jesus' death and resurrection, we are able to experience the good news of Jesus. If you're wondering what it means to be for Jesus to be your friend and to be your Savior, all you need to do is invite him into your life. If you would like to make Jesus the leader of your life, all you have to do is pray a simple prayer and believe it in your heart. Would you bow your head, close your eyes, and believe this with me? Say, "Dear God, thank you for sending your son, Jesus. I believe he lived, died, and rose again just for me. Today I give you my life. Change me, renew me, transform me. I'm yours. In Jesus' name, amen." Way to go! This is big, huge news. This is not something you should keep to yourself. It's time to make some noise about it. Be sure to click on the I Choose Jesus link below to let us know that you made that decision. We want to celebrate with you.
Hey, was it your first time checking out TC Kidz? That means that you are VIP. Now, VIP stands for very important person, and that is you. So click the link below right here that says I'm new to TC Kidz. Can't wait to meet you.
TC Kidz, we had so much fun with you learning all about the Bible. The Bible really is a lamp unto our feet. I loved spending time with you, and I hope you had a good time too. Listen, until next time, we love you, God loves you, and go out and live a transformed life.
The end.